Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. To start today's project, we're gonna need our yarn. I'll be using a 5mm crochet hook and a marker. Now take your yarn and make a slip knot. And then we're just going to go ahead and make 25 chain stitches. Now, after you've made your 25 chain stitches, in the second chain from the hook, go ahead and insert your hook. We're going to hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop. And now we have two loops on our hook. We're going to hook it again to the working yarn and pull that through both loops. And that's going to be our single crochet. And we're going to complete one more single crochet into that same stitch. So insert your hook. Hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop. And with two loops on our hook, hook it again to the working yarn and pull it through both loops. So now we have two single crochets inside that chain stitch. Now we're going to work one single crochet in each of the chain stitches going down. So one there. And one in the stitch beside it. One. 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 Now continue working one single crochet in each stitch until we're at the end. Now once you've completed all your single crochets going to the end, in the last stitch, instead of doing one single crochet, we're going to complete four single crochets inside this stitch. This is our third. And our fourth. And you'll see that doing four single crochets inside the stitch takes the pattern over to this side. And what we're going to do is that we're going to be working one single crochet in each stitch going all the way up. So we already have one single crochet aligned on this side here, so you see 1 1 1, but on the other side we're also going to go ahead and work one single crochet inside those stitches. Now if you have a tail for your yarn, go ahead and place it forward so that we can yarn over it. And in the first stitch, and you'll see it's right, it's opposite to the single crochet on this side, we're going to insert our hook, pull up a loop, and complete a single crochet. And in the stitch beside that, we're going to complete one single crochet inside that stitch. And we're just going to go ahead and do that going all the way down. So wherever there's a single crochet on that side, we're gonna go ahead and complete a single crochet on this side. Now go ahead and continue doing your single crochets until we're at our stitch here. Once you've done your single crochets going down, in the last stitch, we would have already had two single crochets in that stitch here from the beginning. And we're gonna complete two more single crochets inside that stitch, so that we'll have four single crochets in total. Now, remember we have four single crochets down here, so we're pretty much gonna do the same on this end. And to close out the round, we're gonna go ahead and insert our hook in this stitch. So not this one, but in this stitch. We're gonna insert our hook, hook it to the working yarn and pull through a loop. And then we're just gonna go ahead and complete a slip stitch. And that's gonna go ahead and close out the round. Now, once you've done the slip stitch, go ahead and make one chain. And in the first stitch here, we're also gonna go ahead and create a single crochet. Now, I want you to place your markers on this stitch because this is where we're going to be closing out the round in future. Now in each stitch, we're going to go ahead and insert our hook through both loops, hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop and complete a single crochet. But we're only going to be doing one single crochet in each stitch going all the way around. One single crochet. One single crochet. And in the last stitch, we're gonna do one single crochet. Now we're gonna go ahead and remove our marker. But instead of doing a slip stitch the way we did before, we're gonna make this loop a bit larger. And in that stitch where our marker was, we're going to go ahead and insert the hook from the back, hook it to the working yarn, and pull it through. And we're going to do it as tight as we can to pretty much bring this stitch and this stitch as close together as possible. Now once you've done that, you can just go ahead and pull on the working yarn to adjust the loop. Now in the first stitch, which is right here, we're gonna go ahead and do a single crochet, but we're actually gonna do it from below the stitch here. So if you'll notice, there's a stitch that's right here, and we're gonna insert our hook from the bottom of this stitch to do our first stitch. So I'll go ahead and demonstrate. So with our hook inside the loop, we're going to go ahead and move it forward and then insert it below the stitch here. And then we're going to hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop. And then we're going to complete a single crochet. Now once we've done that, go ahead and place the marker back on the stitch here so that you'll know where to close out the round. And in the stitch beside it, we're not going to go ahead and do that single crochet from the bottom as we did before. Instead, we're going to complete our single crochet through this stitch here. So pull up a loop and complete your single crochet. And now that we've done our single crochet at the top, this stitch aligns with this stitch here. So our next stitch would fall at the bottom of this stitch. So insert your hook, pull up a loop, and complete a single crochet. And then we're going to do a single crochet in the stitch beside it. So skipping this one, we're going to go ahead and complete the single crochet from the bottom of this stitch. And then in the stitch beside it, we're going to go ahead and do the single crochet from the top. And we're pretty much going to alternate going all around. So single crochet from the bottom. And then single crochet in the stitch right beside it at the top. So I'll do a few more. Now continue the stitch pattern going all the way around until we're at the marker here. And when we're at the corners, we're just going to go ahead and continue the pattern following the natural layout of the stitches. So don't pull on it too tightly. But instead, work the stitches in naturally where they fall. So we've just done that one. So now we should do the single crochet at the top. And the single crochet at the top here will be our last stitch. So go ahead and make this loop larger. And then we're going to remove our marker. Now insert your hook in that stitch from the back where our marker was. Hook it to the working yarn and we're just going to pull it through as we did in the previous round. And you can tighten it as much as possible to pretty much bring it around here. And once you've tightened it to your liking, you can just go ahead and pull on the working yarn to adjust the loop. Now in the previous round, we had started the stitch from the bottom here, so you'll see this larger V as our first stitch. In this round, we're going to start the stitch from the top. So instead of going from the bottom, at the top of the stitch here, we're going to insert our hook, hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop, and complete a single crochet. Now once you've completed your single crochet, take your marker and place it back on the stitch here so that you'll know where to close out the round. Now in the stitch beside it, you'll see where we have a small V here, which we did at the top. Now it's below that stitch where we'll be completing our next single crochet. So below the stitch here, insert our hook, pull up a loop, and then complete your single crochet. And in the stitch beside it, like we've done before, we're gonna complete our single crochet from the top of the stitch beside it. So pull up a loop and complete your single crochet at the top. And then where we had a smaller V, we're gonna insert our hook below that V, pull up a loop, and complete our single crochet. And you'll see where this stitch pretty much covers the stitch from the previous round. And then the stitch right beside it, we're gonna go ahead and complete the stitch from the top. And we're going to alternate going all the way around. So we've done it from the bottom there, and beside it, we're gonna do a smaller single crochet at the top, the larger one from the bottom. And in the stitch beside it, a smaller one from the top. And we're gonna do this going all the way around. As you see, we've created one of the larger stitches for the last stitch. And we're gonna go ahead and close out the round in the same way we did the previous round. And then adjust it on our hook. So you see that now when we're beginning the round, it's one of the smaller V's. So whenever we have that, we're gonna go ahead and insert our hook from the bottom of the stitch, hook it to the working yarn, and pull up a loop, and then complete a single crochet. And of course, we're gonna place our marker back here so that we'll know where to close out the round, and we'll do this in each round going forward. And you'll see that this is one of the larger V's. So to the top of that stitch, we're gonna complete one of the small V's at the top. And then a large single crochet there, and then to the top a small one. And we're pretty much going to complete this pattern as we've done in the previous rounds. So go ahead and continue doing that, and then we're gonna close out the round in the exact same way that we did before. As you see here, this is one of the large V's, so we'll have to start the round with a small one, and then we're going to alternate in each round going upwards. So wherever there's a large V, to the top we do a small one, and wherever there's a small V, we go ahead and complete the single crochet from the bottom of the stitch. Now I'm gonna go ahead and complete 28 rounds in total, and I'll see you when we're at the 28th round. So this is how our project looks after completing 28 rounds. But I'm gonna go ahead and close out the round completely, and I won't be doing it in the same way as we've done going up. Instead, we're gonna go ahead and cut our yarn. And pull it all the way through. And we won't be joining it where our marker is. Instead, we'll be doing it in the stitch beside it. Now, if you have a crochet needle, go ahead and thread the needle with your yarn. And again, not in this stitch here, but in the stitch beside it, we're going to go ahead and insert our needle and pull the yarn through. Now, once you've done that, you can go ahead and remove the crochet hook so that you won't be confused. And we're going to pull on our yarn until we have fairly the same size here as all the other stitches. And then we're going to insert our needle inside the stitch at the top, as well as through the bump that's right here. So here. And then we're going to pull the yarn through. And once that's done, we're just going to go ahead and insert our needle in some of the stitches here at the back so that we can hold the yarn in place. And once you've done that, you can just go ahead and cut your yarn from the inside. Now, before we start our next round, we're gonna go ahead and just pull on the stitches that fall in the extreme middle of our project. So that would be here and here. And we're gonna count to 7 stitches from each of these. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Which falls here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, which falls here. And we're just gonna go ahead and place markers on this stitch. So here, we're gonna place a marker. And we're gonna place another marker here. And we're also gonna place markers in the stitches that fall right behind these. So if you turn your work, you'll see that this stitch aligns with it. So we're gonna place a marker there. And we're gonna do the same here. Now I've pretty much done this to scope out where we're gonna go ahead and place our handles, and now we can start the next round. Now take your yarn, and towards the end here, we're just gonna go ahead and insert it into our project. So insert your hook under the stitch, and you can pretty much do this anywhere. I just prefer to start at the extreme end. Hook it to the working yarn and pull up a loop. And then we're just going to go ahead and complete the stitch. And in the stitch beside it, we're going to go ahead and do a single crochet. And we can go ahead and use another marker and place it here, because this is where we'll be closing out our round. And of course, placing the tail forward, we're going to yarn over it. For the top of the project though, I'm going to be doing single crochets going all the way around. You can of course continue the pattern if you would prefer that. That works as well, but I'd like to go ahead and finish this off with a few rows of single crochets at the top. Now, wherever there is a marker, however, we're going to skip that stitch. So you can chain one, and skipping the stitch here, we're going to complete a single crochet in the stitch beside it, and then continue our single crochets. And again, wherever we have a marker, we're just going to go ahead and chain one, skip the stitch there, and in the stitch beside that, we're going to complete our single crochet. And then continue doing single crochets going around. Now, I want you to continue doing your stitches until you're at your markers over here. And wherever we have a marker, just go ahead and chain one, and then skip these stitches. And I'll see you when we're here. In the last stitch, and you'll see here where we have our marker from the beginning of the round, we're gonna go ahead and close out the round in the same fashion as we did in the rounds going up. So make your loop a bit larger here and then remove your marker. Insert your hook from the back and hook it to the loop and pull it through. And once that's done, go ahead and pull on the working yarn to adjust the loop. Now go ahead and insert your hook and complete a single crochet. And we're going to place our marker back on this stitch here, so that we'll know where to close out the round. And then we're gonna go ahead and continue doing single crochets going all the way around. Now in this round, we're not gonna go ahead and make any skips. We're just gonna go ahead and do single crochets in each stitch going all around. Now we have 1, 2 rounds. I'm gonna go ahead and complete 3 in total, and again close out the round as we've done previously. And I'll see you when I've completed the 3rd round. And we're just going to go ahead and do our final stitch. And once you've completed your single crochet, we're actually not going to close out the round as we've done the last 2. Instead, we're going to close out the round with a slip stitch. So go ahead and remove your marker. And it's in this stitch here that we're gonna do our first slip stitch. So hook it to the working yarn and pull it through. And then pull that through the loop already on the hook. And that's gonna be our first slip stitch. And then you can just go ahead and place your marker on that stitch so that you'll know where to close out the round. And then we're gonna go ahead and continue doing slip stitches going all around. So in the next stitch, hook it to the working yarn, pull through a loop, and then pull that loop through the loop already on the hook. Now the slip stitch to me gives the project a nice finish, so I love ending my projects this way. And if you'd like to do that as well, just go ahead and continue doing slip stitches until we're here. Now in our last stitch, we're gonna go ahead and complete our slip stitch. And then we're gonna just pull up the yarn a bit. And then we're gonna cut our yarn. Now pull it all the way through. And we're gonna just go ahead and also remove the stitch marker from the last stitch. And if you have a crochet needle, go ahead and thread your crochet needle with the yarn. And we're just going to go ahead and insert it into the first slip stitch that we had there. So we're going to place the needle under the stitch and pull the yarn through. And then we're just going to go ahead and bring the yarn forward, and we want to make it about as large as the other slip stitches that are there, and pull it forward, and then you're just going to insert the needle into the last stitch, and we're going to do this all the way through to the back, and then we're going to pull our yarn through. And you'll see where it looks seamless. And then we're just going to go ahead and insert our remaining yarn here in the stitches at the back to hide it. Now I'm going to go ahead and make our handles. Now for the straps, we're just going to go ahead and make a slip stitch to start. And then we're going to chain two, so that's one, two. Now insert your hook into the first chain, and you're just going to go ahead and pull up a loop. And now we'll have two loops on our hook. Now release the first loop, and then we're going to go ahead and yarn over with our working yarn and pull it through the loop that was on the hook. And then we're gonna insert our hook back into that loop that we released, hook it on our working yarn, and pull through a loop. And then we're just gonna go ahead and continue that process. So release the first loop, and we're gonna be left with one loop on our hook, hook it to the working yarn, and pull through a loop. And then we're gonna place back that loop that we released back on the yarn, hook it to the working yarn, and pull it through that loop only. And we're just going to repeat that going all the way up. And of course, you can go ahead and do this as long as you'd like until you're at the desired length for your strap. Once your strap is at the desired length, you can just go ahead and hook it to the working yarn and pull it through both loops. And you can make this a bit large, because we're going to use that yarn in the end. And then you can just go ahead and cut it. And pull it all the way through. Now we're going to take our project, and wherever we have a marker is where we'll be inserting the straps. Now once the straps have been inserted, we're just going to go ahead and attach the sides together so that we can go ahead and complete the project completely. So remember where we had cut our yarn before? I want you to go ahead and loosen it a bit until we can clearly see the two loops where we had pulled the yarn through. And taking our crochet needle, we're just going to go ahead and thread the needle with our yarn. We're just going to go ahead and yarn through it with our needle. And once it's been fastened, then we're just going to go ahead and work our yarn through the middle here to hide it. And then cut the yarn. And just repeat for the tail here. Now once you're finished, your project should look something like this. And of course, you can also pull on this side to wear the straps short or long, depending on how you'd like to wear it. Now this pretty much concludes my tutorial. Please remember to like this video, subscribe to my channel, and let me know, of course, if you have any questions in the comments. Bye!